The Orks, or Greenskins, are a fearsome xeno species spread throughout the galaxy. They pose a large, constant threat to all other races in the Warhammer 40K universe. Their crude but effective technology and ability to loot and repurpose tech from their defeated enemies, combined with their natural size and resilience, make them mighty warriors. Their lust for battle usually means they will fight until either they or their enemy are dead. But despite being regarded as unintelligent by other races, they possess a cunning and innate grasp of the battlefield that will often surprise any commander who dares underestimate them. They threaten entire sectors with their onslaught and ensnare the Imperium in dire sieges, such as those in the city of Brosharok or on the world of Armageddon. But where did the Orks come from? They were originally a biologically engineered species created by an ancient, very technologically advanced, and psychically powerful race called the Old Ones, over 60 million years before the 41st millennium. They were originally called the Krork by their creators, and were equipped with far more advanced armor and weaponry. They, along with other servant races, were used as a last-ditch weapon in the Old Ones' devastating interstellar war against the Necron, called the War in Heaven. This relation to their ancient Old Ones' masters is still hinted at by modern-day Orks in their referral to their ancestors, the Brain Boys. The Orks continued to draw upon the skills they need to conduct war that was ingrained in their very DNA by their creators. They do not think about how to make weapons, repair vehicles, or wage war. They simply know. But how does a species bred entirely for war keep from tearing itself apart over 60 million years? Well, Ork society, if you can call it that, is ruled by force, where might makes right. The biggest and the baddest rise to the top, as orcs have a natural instinct to obey those larger than themselves, as long as it's an orc. Though this results in much internal fighting and power struggles, it establishes a loose social hierarchy. The smallest social and fighting group of orcs are called mobs. A group of mobs make up a warband, multiple warbands make up a tribe. Outside of those groupings, an orc generally belongs to a clan. The clan represents a philosophical grouping reflected in different fighting styles, physical markings, and preferences. At the top are war bosses and warlords. Usually impressively large and mean, even by orc standards, although occasionally a shaman or mech boy may scheme his way into power as well. Orcs are normally divided into many bickering clans, but may be united by a war boss to form a WA. The war boss holds the orcs together and gives them purpose. If a war boss is defeated, either from an external threat or a mutiny from within, it can throw the whole society into upheaval with an ensuing power struggle. The will of the war boss is enforced by the Nobs, a ruling caste of elite orcs who have distinguished themselves as being bigger, more aggressive, and more successful than the average orc, and therefore are richer and have better gear. They can stand 7 to 10 feet tall, easily as tall and wide as a space marine in full armor. The most loot-hungry of these Nobs may be designated as flash gits, as they acquire more wealth, bigger guns, and customized equipment. Some orcs, known as odd boys, possess a natural gift, enabling them to provide essential roles in orc society. This knowledge is infused in their DNA, and not something learned. A few of these are the mech boys, who specialize in technology and build and repair orc weaponry and other gadgets. They're known for constructing vehicles and scrap titan gargants, capable of rivaling those of the Adeptus Mechanicus. The pain boys, that serve as surgeons and doctors for the orcs, often grafting parts from a dead orc onto a living orc, which will heal and function normally. And the weird boys, that are powerful orc psychers, able to channel the power of the warp, or channel the latent power of the average orcs. Orcs have a combined gestalt psychic power that allows them to impact the world around them based on what they believe, which is credited to allowing much of their technology to function as effectively as it does, despite being crudely crafted, or having things painted red go faster, or yellow exploding bigger. Although the extent of the practical effects of this are debatable, in the mind of an orc, it is true. Below the Nobs are the average orc boys, that make up the bulk of their forces. On average, they are not too bright and not much use in mundane tasks, so spend much of their time fighting, racing, or competing with other orcs. They are generally about 6 to 7 feet tall and much stockier than a human. The number of orc boys depends on the size of the horde. It could range from a small raiding band, a ship of privateers, all the way to a system-spanning empire or a massive wa. Then there are the Gretchen, who are often found in supporting roles on the battlefield, as scouts, snipers, special weapon crews, or expendable infantry. But their main role is performing all the tasks necessary to keep orcish society working, such as harvesting and preparing food, looting battlefields, or constructing buildings. Despite being smaller than the orcs, they are crafty and have carved out an important role for themselves. At the bottom of orcish society are the snotlings, that are much smaller and less intelligent than any of their orcish counterparts. Due to this, they are not much use in battle. They reproduce very quickly, so may be used as food or cannon fodder, though. Their main benefit comes from their natural affinity with squigs and in cultivating useful fungi. The squigs are essential to the orcs as food, transport, attack beasts, or living bombs. But how, despite constant battles, both external and internal, do the orcs maintain their high population? Well, not in the usual way. Despite their appearance, orcs have no gender and are actually fungus. This is likely the reason for their green skin, robust nature, and resistance to pain. They release spores, especially after meeting a violent end, that grow to produce all orcoid species, starting with the snotlings and squids, and eventually producing full-grown orc boys. This makes an orc invasion especially difficult to eradicate, because after they have set foot on a planet, they will continue to regrow, and subsequent attacks will occur years after they had been thought to be defeated. Great lengths need to be taken to fully eradicate orcs from a planet. An orc ship may crash on a planet and kill all the fully grown orcs aboard, and yet their spores grow afterwards. This can lead to a feral orc tribe growing in isolation, where in the absence of higher technology, they will resort to primitive weapons and tactics. This has been just a brief overview of some of the interesting aspects of orc lore. They have a very unique backstory, which makes them stand out from your typical orcs from other settings. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more content.